weed of the week is not milkweed. This is not common milkweed. I don't know how many times, Brian, somebody has said, hey, what are you doing with that milkweed? This is not milkweed. This is hemp dogbane.
It is kind of confusing because when you go out to the field, it looks a lot like common milkweed. You bust the stem open, there's a little milk on the inside. It's a perennial weed. It's tough to control. It's got kind of waxy leaves. But yes, it is a different weed. It's hemp dogbane.
Well, definitely a thinner stem, a little thinner leaf to it. And you see the coloration is different than common milkweed. You can definitely tell once you know, oh, okay, it's not, I can see the difference out there, but you're right. The milk in the stem is what really throws people off.
Okay, so for Darren and me, when we were kids, we had to walk beans. We eventually then had to ride beans and spray Roundup out there to kill weeds. There are a few things that we learned from back then about hemp dogbane that we'll share with you today. Number one, pulling the weed doesn't work. You'd pull it up and eventually a new plant would come and you're like, what? Well, that all has to do
is just pull it up one time, because you'll pull, it'll snap, and all you'll have is a stem. You won't have a root system. And when you do some digging with the shovel, you'll see there's lots of roots that are running across underneath the soil and popping up new shoots.
Right, it's a perennial weed, so it's gonna be tough to control with that. The next thing that we learned is don't put so much water with your spray. This is a very waxy weed. It's got waxy leaves, I mean. And so when you have too much water, then everything rolls right off.
Well,
so what you want is
coverage.
Low water and high volume of whatever spray it is you're using, hopefully Roundup.
Everybody wants to put so many gallons out there to get great coverage, and that's cool on a lot of weeds, but on this one, you need a concentrated droplet because you won't get many to stick.
Yep, absolutely. The other thing that we learned is, hey, if you want to eliminate this weed with Roundup, ideally, you'd like to do it in the spring or the fall. Well, you don't have a whole bunch of crop in the field, so you can use a really high rate of Roundup. But the other thing is you've got to have good weather conditions. So if you're spraying it in the spring and it's too cold, your Roundup isn't going to work as good as you want it to work.
Let's talk control. If you're in wheat, you have to start with the Roundup burn down. That's really the only success you're going to see. In corn, you can start with that Roundup burn down. In crop, Status would be your best option. In soybeans, definitely plant Roundup Ready soybeans. This is one of those weeds where Roundup works way better than Liberty.
Okay, and post-emerge in wheat, that'd probably go Husky. In soybeans, preferably we'd like to see you have Enlist or Extend, but otherwise, obviously, Roundup is great post-emerge as well.
That's all the time we have for our Weed of the Week, but Iron Talk is coming up next.